protoplasm. What is mean by protoplasm? A life giving materials are present, the entire total living materials are present in the cell. We call the word is protoplasm. Proto means is a first, plasm means is a form. Now this is a protoplasm or a includes mostly cell membrane, cytoplasm and a nucleus. This protoplasm is a mostly life giving material, physical basis of life. We have to commonly described the word is physical basis of life. Now the protoplasm is described as a translucent, partially to allow the what means a light, adukku translucent fluid, translucent fluid which is colorless, there is no any color, or even if it is the color is present mean a grayish in color or brownish in color, brownish in color. Now the protoplasm is mainly consists of a sum of the item, that is a most of the what means water, proteins, carbohydrate and fats, minerals, mineral salts, amino acids, ions. These are present in the protoplasm. This is giving the what means a life, a physical basis of life. That is a discovered by Purkinje. A scientist name is Purkinje. Okay, the next. This protoplasm. Apart from this, some of the structures are present within the cytoplasm of the cell. The cell is do the what means a metabolic infection. As the result of the metabolism in the cells, unwanted or a non-living substances are produced within the cytoplasm of the cell. These non-living substance present in the cytoplasm of the cells are called cell inclusion. Cell inclusion. These cell inclusions are includes some of the substances like starch granule, secretory granule and some of the item like that is called calcium carbonate, silica material, inorganic silica material, calcium oxalate. These are non-living substances are produced as the result of metabolic reaction in the cell. These are called non-living structures are present within the cytoplasm of the cell is known as cell inclusion. Okay, prokaryotic cell and eukaryotic cells. Cells basically divisible into two main types based on internal structure and nucleus. Prokaryotic cell and eukaryotic cell. Eukaryotic cell. Prokaryotic cells. These are cells with a primitive type of nucleus. Primitive type of nucleus. Called, that nucleus is called incipient nucleus or nucleoid. Incipient nucleus or nucleoid. In simple word, primitive. What is mean by primitive? A first formed nucleus. Primitive means first formed. Pro. Pro means is a first. First. Karyot means is a nucleus. First formed nucleus. First formed nucleus. Now, in this type, in prokaryotic cell, mostly the nuclear material, the nuclear material is not surrounded by any membrane. That is a nuclear membranes are absent. Nuclear membranes are absent. Now in this case, the all the cell organelles, a minute structure which are present inside of the cytoplasm of the cell, are called cell organelles. The cell organelles are not separated. That is not separated. These cell organelles are not enveloped by membrane. Membrane. There is no lacking of membrane. If we learn the what means mitochondria, that is a mitochondria has the two membranes. mitochondria, two membranes. Now, there is no any membrane, lack of membrane. Mitochondria, Golgi apparatus, chloroplast, like etc. etc. Now, that is a membrane bounded cell organelles are absent. In this case, the organisms with prokaryotic cell, that is we call the word is prokaryotes, that organisms are called prokaryotes. What are the example of the prokaryotes? Do you know, Mr. Kaushik Shankar? We learned already cell previous year. Now, example, yes, bacteria, blue-green algae, also called cyanobacteria, blue-green algae also called cyanobacteria. These are example for prokaryotic organism. This is a simplified, a first formed nucleus. There is no any membrane bounded organelle. Next we go for the next part. Eukaryotic. What is mean by eukaryotic? U means true. Karyote means is a nucleus. True nucleus bearing cell are called eukaryotic cells. All the higher plant cells, animal cells, including the human cells, eukaryotic cells. U means is a well-defined nucleus. We learned already that is a nucleus structure. This is a nucleus, nuclear membrane. Inside it has a, what means nucleolus, chromatin reticulum. This is a organized, advanced, a form of nucleus bearing cells are called eukaryotic cells. Eukaryote, U means true. Now, advanced organized nucleus. This is organized nucleus. In eukaryotic cell, the nucleus and organelles are mostly enveloped by double walled membrane. Membrane bounded organelles are present like mitochondria, endoplasmic reticulum, Golgi apparatus, that is a chloroplast. These are mostly present in the cells. That cells are known as eukaryotic cells. Now, the organisms with prokaryotic cell. The organism with eukaryotic cells are called eukaryotes. Eukaryotes. All plant cell and animal cell are called eukaryotes. Next. The structure, this structure very clearly shows the what means a plant cell structure. Outer cell wall, inside is a cell membrane, all the organelles, large vacuoles and nucleus, well organized nucleus, nuclear membrane, nucleolus, endoplasmic reticulum, all the organelles are well defined. This cell is a example for eukaryotic cells. The next, this is a animal cell. The animal cell is generally very small in size, well defined nucleus, all the organelles are present. The outermost covering is called cell membrane and cytoplasm and nucleus. The next, now the both the features, compare the what means is a compare and contrast the what means a plant cell and animal cell. Now, the plant cell, that is animal cell, that side, both the cells, that is a both the future, presence of mitochondria are present in both the plant cell and animal cell. Golgi apparatus are present in both the plant cell and animal cell. Rough endoplasmic reticulum and nucleus, cytoplasm and ribosomes, all these cell organelles are sharing with both the plant cell and animal cell. Apart from this, contrast. Now that is say differences. Outermost covering of the plant cell is called cell wall. Cell wall, rigid, thick cell wall is present. Here there is no any cell wall. Outer covering is called cell membrane. Vacuoles are large vacuole. vacuoles are, in this case plant cell large vacuole is present, the vacuoles are less in number. In animal cell the vacuoles are mostly is absent, whether if it present the vacuoles are very small and no vacuoles. The next is chloroplasts are present in the plant cell. The chloroplasts are absent in the, what means is here, no chloroplast is seen in the animal cell. The next is flagella only found in the gametes. The flagella is here present. Flagella, small minute structures which are developed from the at any parts of our cell. This is a differences between the, what means is a plant cell and animal cell. Apart from this, in plant cell the Golgi apparatus, GA, Golgi complex, Golgi apparatus in plant cells are called dictyosomes, very small structure. A prominent Golgi apparatus is present. Golgi apparatus is a prominent means very large in size, which is present in the animal cell. Now centrosome and centrioles are absent in plant cell. Instead of this, polar caps are present. Here centrosome and centrioles are present. This is a differences between plant cell and animal cell. So I hope you have to learn about the, what means a prokaryotic cell and a eukaryotic cell. What is the difference? We learn very elaborately. End of this video session, I have enclosed PPT, study material, question bank, need oriented questions and all attached. Thank you.
கடைபிடித்து உடல் மண்டலம் தேடி அன்றாட வேலையை